Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. So in this today's video, we're gonna learn how we can create an Angular add to cart. Okay, so this is just a quick demo where we will see what things we are going to build in this application. All right, so I'll start from the top that we have this search bar functionality where you can search your product. Okay, suppose you have this n number of products, so if you want to search like for men products, like men's, then you can just type in there and it will be shown to you. And secondly, we have this feature for what we say, a categorized way of filtering. Suppose if you want to check for electronic products, then you just have to click on the electronics. You can click on this fashion product to check out all the fashion items. Then you can click on jewelry product, it will filter it out. All right, okay. So suppose if you want to add a product, just have to click on this add to cart button and the product will be added here. You can see we have two items has been added. Let me add this third one as well. You can see the number has been changed. And let's go into the cart and check. Okay, so yeah, you can see we have this table here where you will have your product image and descriptions and price and everything. And the bottom you will see the grand total of this whole three item. If suppose you want to remove one product, that you can do from here. You just have to click on this delete button and the product will be removed, okay, from the list. And if suppose you want to empty the cart, then you just have to click on this empty cart and you can see your cart has been empty right now. If you look at this UI, I just created this UI. I just had a reference of this UI from the Flipkart. You can see in the Flipkart add to cart, it has the same UI. So we will try to make use of the same UI inside our application as well. All right. So without any delay, let's start our video. Okay, guys. So before starting the video, there are a few things which we need to look on. Okay. If you want to create this Angular add to cart, you must have Node and Angular installed in your system. If you don't know how to do it, so I have a dedicated video on my channel where you can just refer it and you can install these two first. Okay, so second thing, we need to have create a new application. And how we can do it, the command is ng new and the project name. So I will have the project name as add to cart. You can give any name whatever you feel like. All right, the third step is we need to add Bootstrap, and the fourth is we need to add font awesome, like whatever font we are using in our application. So I will not follow from the first step because I have already installed these two in my system. I'll try to start from the step number two. So let me create that. Okay, I create our new application. Let me go inside my folder and let me just open my CMD. Okay, I will create the application by the command ng new and the application name add to cart. Hit enter. Alright guys, so our application has been installed successfully. Let me just go inside my application folder by using this command cd and add to cart. Hit enter and let's open up our VS code. So how you can do it, you just have to type code dot and it will open up inside your VS code. Okay. Alright, let's have a look what we get. Okay, so we have this node module, source folder and everything. Okay, so now let me start things off with the step number 3 now, because step number 2 has been done. Now we need to add Bootstrap now. So let's do that. For adding Bootstrap, you just have to go on Google, just type Bootstrap. You just have to copy this CSS file and paste inside your index.html. Wherever I'll show you. You have to just paste it inside this head tag. Okay. Okay. The second thing, you need to copy the bundles, like JS bundles. Just copy it and just paste inside this body and save it. Okay. So now let's check what is the step number 4. Now we need to add font awesome kit. Okay, so for that just go to the Google and search for font awesome. Right guys, so from this website you just have to press on this start for free and you need to put your email address here and they will send you the kit to your mail ID. If you don't want to do this, then I'll just provide the kit, okay, in the description below. The kit will be look like something like this. It is just a script. Okay, you just have to copy this script and you have to paste it inside your index.html, just like how I'm doing it. Okay, so inside it, you in the head tag, you just have to paste the script, okay, and just save it. All right, so now what we'll do, we'll just try to run our application. Okay, so let me do that. What is the command to run? The command is ng serve open. Okay, so it will compile your application, everything, and it will run on your localhost 4200. All right, so let's wait till the application gets open. As you can see, I'm getting this a warning here that my 4200 port is already occupied, so it is asking me for a different port. I will say no. Okay, so suppose if you guys are facing this kind of thing, then what to do? Okay, so just press ng serve minus minus port and give the port on which you want to run your application. I will give 4100 and hit enter. Okay, so now our application will run on 4100. Okay, as you can see, our application has been compiled successfully and it is serving on localhost 4100. Let's copy this link and try to open on the browser. So this is what we get, okay, when we run our application. So now let's just remove everything. Okay, just give a heading. Just save and check on the browser if things are. Yeah, so our application is running completely fine. Okay, so now I'll just discuss on what things we need for creating this application. Okay, so I'll just talk about whatever components we will create now. Okay, when you look at our application here, okay, so let me open up my application which I've already created here. Okay, so when you see here, so we have this header, then we have this dashboard for product list, and then we have a cart. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll just create a component now. Okay, and I'll try to code everything inside our component, because in Angular we have this component which is the basic building block. All right, so let's try to create the component now. Okay, so I'll have a folder here with the name as component. Okay, and inside our component, I need to create a few components now. So let us try to create components now. And how to create component? I'll tell you how, like what are the commands to create a component. So we need to have a component called header. So we'll go ahead and hit this command ng, g for generate, c for component, and I want to have the component inside this component folder. So I'll just give component slash, and inside this component folder, I want to have a header component. So I'll just type the name of the component, header, and hit enter. As you can see, our component has been created. Let me open this folder, and there you go, we have this header component now. Okay, so let me try to create the second component. So the command is same, ng generate, c for component, and inside the component folder I need to have a component called cart. Let's verify. Yeah, our second component has been created successfully. Now we need to create a component called product. Component slash product. We can say products because it will have the list of products. So the name is products. Hit enter. Alright, so our three component has been created: cart, header, and this products. Alright, and also I will need a service call, because I will call an API. This is the API, this is a fake API which I am going to use. Okay, I'll provide the link in the description as well. So I'm going to use this API to fetch all the product list. Alright, so I will have a service for that to call the API. Alright, so I'll create a service inside this app. Okay, let me just, yeah, create a folder service, and inside the service I will create a service now. Okay, so how we can create a service? The command is ng, g for generate, s for service, and the service name. And but we are creating the service inside this service folder, so I will have the name of this service folder. Okay, service slash API service, hit enter. So as you can see, inside my service folder my API service has been created. All right, so let's start. So let's just try to create the template first. We will start things off with the header template. Okay, so we'll try to style everything and just first make the header, all right, for you guys. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll just as the requirement says that we need to have a nav bar, okay, on the top. So there is a navigation bar. So I'll have a header here first. Inside my header I will have a div tag, okay, and div with the class as nav bar, because we are using Bootstrap here, so we can make use of Bootstrap classes. And the nav bar should have a background as primary. Okay, and I want to give a shadow, small shadow. Okay, shadow, so that you can do from here, the shadow small. All right, so now we have a div with a nav. Now basically we have a nav bar on the top with the background as bg primary. Let me save this. Okay, it is compiling successfully. I'll check the compilation as well, it is successful or not. Alright guys, so we have created the nav bar. Okay, let's check on the browser how it looks. Let me open here. So now we have this nav bar. Okay, it is not looking right now. Let's have a logo first, then it will be visible. Okay, so let's try to create a logo now. So I will have a div. Okay, so div with the class as nav bar brand. Okay. Alright, and I will give align the item center. Item center, okay, and also I will make use of display flex by using the class dflex. Okay, hit enter. All right, so now what I need to have, I need to have an icon. Okay, icon for that logo. Okay, so I will make use of this I with the class as, so this class is basically I'm using the font.awesome class. Okay, so it will have shipping. Okay, and inside the icon I will have the name as name of our application. So I can just try to give name as Flipkart. Okay, and let's save it and check what we get on the browser. Okay, so we are having this logo and also we have this called as Flipkart. Okay, so what I'll try to do now, let's try to increase the font size. Okay, let's style it by and increase the font size to 40 pixel maybe. Yeah, save it and check. All right, so we have this now with logo and this flip card. Okay, so let me just give some space by using nbsp. Okay, so we have created this now on the header. Now what we need, we just need to have a search bar here. Okay, let's try to have a search bar now. Okay, so inside our div, so below this I will have one more div now. Okay, oh sorry, it should not come inside this icon, it should be outside it, and save and check. Now it looks good. Let's try to increase the size of this as well, style, and we need to increase the font size to maybe 20 pixel and check, maybe 30. Okay, looks good now. All right, now let's try to have that search box. Okay, so I will have one more div below this with the class as form group. Okay, and inside it I will have an input type text. Okay, and I will have a placeholder for that search product. Save and let's check on the browser. Okay, so I have this input box now. Let me try to style this input. Okay, so I'm going to my HTML file. I will have a class as form control, and I will make use of this class inside my CSS. browser. All right, so I have this form, good looking input form now. Okay, so now what I'll have to do, I want to have this icon here. So let's try to implement it now. So inside my HTML file, I will go and just have that icon inside my span tag. Okay, so below this div, what I will do, I will have this particular span. And I'll try to use this search icon inside my CSS. Okay, so for the search icon, it should be on like on your form. It should be on your form basically. So for that, we need to make use of this position absolute. Okay, and we need to give an index as 10 maybe, so that it should look above it. And I'll give a right should be something around 40%. We'll check on the UI as well how we can change the color and everything. Okay, let me initially give a color as blue and let me save everything and let's check on the browser what we get. Okay, so here you can see I have this icon. So let me try to just inspect it and just try to change the CSS from here. Let me open this. Okay, let me make use of the icon. I need to. Alright. And I'll just give a top as 10 pixel, 20 pixel, yes, and right as 50%. Okay, so I need to have right as 50% and top as 20 pixel. Let me save it and just check on the browser. Yeah, looks good. Okay, so now what I need to have, so currently we have this logo, we have this search icon, and now need to implement this button for this card button. All right, so let's try to do that now. Okay, let me open up my HTML and yeah, let me have that button basically so that I can easily navigate to that. So below it I will have my button now. Okay, let this hit enter here. Yeah, so this is our nav bar. So below that I need to have a button. Okay, so let's have a button. And inside my button I will have an icon for that card. So how I can have it, I just have to I'm just making use of the class of font awesome. Okay, so you guys can just google it out how I can have icons for that. So I'm making use of that icon and I'll try to style it a bit, and I'll give a font size to something around 30 pixel to it. Okay, let me save things and let's check on the browser. Okay, so I have this button with this icon. Okay, alright, so now it should also display the number, like what is the number it has and all that. Okay, so for that I will have a div. Okay, and I'll give a font size to that as need to have a style, and the font size would be 10 pixel. Let me save things and check on the browser. Okay, so I have this now, this button. So button not looking good. Let's try to check why. Okay, so the class name was incorrect. It should be btn. Let's save it and check now. Alright, okay, so our header is basically ready. Okay, so now here if you just try to check what we have here and here, it looks identical now. Okay, this completed. Now let's just focus on the dashboard page. Okay, so in the dashboard we have this first. So this is basically recorded as card top, and below that I will have list of product. Okay, so let's just focus on this part first, the card top. Okay, so let's try to do that. So inside this div I will have the items name, okay, that all product and all that stuff. Okay, let me save it. Let me just try to style this card top first inside my CSS. Okay, now let me try to put some item inside my basically card item. Okay, so I will have an item inside that is, it will be basically a link, a anchor tag. Okay, inside that I will have an image and also a header for that. Okay, so I'll have an anchor tag. So let me have this anchor. Let me remove this href for now because I think we will route to a button, or we can have a click event for this, for just having to trigger that event. So I will have an image with a source. Okay, so for the source I will put all the image source inside the description. Just go ahead and copy all the source. Okay, from there let me copy one by one the source which I have got. Let me paste it for the all products. Okay, and let me have a header for that. So I will make use of h6 and I will have header as all products. Okay, let me save and check. Okay, yeah, all we need to do is we just need to change all this image, okay, which we are seeing right now. So let me have all the source images for the electronics, fashion and jewelries. Let me copy this. Okay, let me save it and check on the browser what we get. Okay, so the image size has to be changed now. Let me do that now. So inside my item I'll have all these images. So let me have a style for item. Okay, and inside my item I have my images. I'll just give a width as a 64 pixel maybe, and let me save and check now on the browser what we get. Okay, now things looks good. Okay, now I'll just have to change the styling so that it just have some gap, okay, because it looks very jumbled. Now let's have change the item. I have this class item and just give a margin as on the top bottom I need 0 and for left right I need to have a fixed 15 pixel of margin, and I will align all the text to center. Okay, so text align should be center. Let me save and check now. Now it looks good. So this is a little bit distorted. Let's try to fix it. Let me write an inline CSS for it because it is a different image which I am using. So let me create an inline CSS for this image. Let me have a style as a 62 pixel, and let me give some, sorry, I need to have here now width as 62 pixel, and also need to give a margin top as 5 pixel. Let me save and let's check on the browser. Yeah, now it looks good. On the hover I need to just change the color, this black color to blue color. Let's try to do that now. So how we can do, we just have to use the pseudo classes of CSS. So inside my item I have my anchor tag, and for anchor hover I need to change the color to blue. Okay, let me save and let's check. Now when I hover the color gets changed to blue. Okay, so now we have completed this part also. Okay, so now we have to focus on this now card, whatever card we have, this product card basically. Okay, let's try to do that. All right, so guys, we have completed this navigation on the top, which is the navigation nav bar and the card top of the dashboard. Okay, so now let's just focus on creating these cards. Okay, this product cards. All right, so this product data is coming from an API, okay, which I have already told before starting the video. So this is the API link. Okay, let me copy this and let me show you in the postman what I am getting. Let me try to paste this inside this and just try to hit on send. Okay, so now the response which I am getting is, I am getting all the product item. Okay, with the product ID, title, price, description, category and the image. Okay, of the product. So I am making use of this particular API, okay, inside my application. All right, so let me just try to make use of it. How I can basically call this this API. So for that I have created a service, API service. Okay, so inside this API service I'll do the call, HTTP call. Alright, so we need to do two things first. Okay, so first of all we need to import HTTP client module inside our app module.ts file. Okay, so let first import this HTTP client module, and from where you have imported, we have imported from angular/common/HTTP. Alright, so once you have imported this HTTP client module, so inside your API service, what you have to inject, you just have to inject HTTP client. So let's try to do it. I will have a name as HTTP and I will call HTTP client. Just press on tab button. Yeah, it is automatically imported as well. On the top you can see. Okay, let me save this. Right. Now let's create a method for calling the API. So I will have a method get product. Okay, and inside it, what I will do, I'll just make use of this call, HTTP call. So I will return the item like this dot HTTP dot get. But I need to get all the list of API. So I need to hit this particular API, okay, to make the get call. So here I'll just paste it. Okay, I'll just pipe it and I'll make use of the map operator. Okay. So how you can make use of map operator? It is basically an RxJS concept, okay, which you have to make use of here inside your application. So let's try to import it. So we'll import map from, you have to import it from RxJS, okay, RxJS/operators. Now inside your pipe you need to map, okay, and inside the map you need to take the response, okay, and that response you need to return, because we are not making any change to the response. We are just returning it. Okay, so I'll return the response wherever it is being called. Okay, let me save it. So our API service is ready now. We just need to call this API inside our product list. Okay, so let's go inside our product list. Okay, so now here inside my ng-init, I will call that particular service. Okay, so before that I must have a property where I can store all the product list. Okay, so I'll create a property, public product list. Okay, now what I'll do, I'll store all the product which is coming from the API inside this. Okay, so now I have to make use the API service. So what I will do, I will just inject the API service which I have created. So it is private API. I'll just type API service. So you can see on the top, you can see, you just have to press tab, it will get auto imported. Okay, imported from the source/service/API service. Okay, so now I'll just make a call here, API call inside my ng oninit. So I'll say this dot API dot, I have this get product method. Okay, I'll just subscribe the method. Okay, on subscribing I'll get a success response. Inside the response I'll just store whatever I'm getting from the response, I'll store inside this product list. Okay, and you guys know what I'm getting inside the response. I'm getting this list of product, okay, which I have showed you on the postman. All right so now I have all the product list data inside this. Okay, so now what I have to do, I just have to make use of a card here. Okay, so I'll just create a card inside my product list, so where I will loop all the data. Okay, so let me create a div with a class container and div with a row below it. So let me just format it a bit. Yeah, so now inside my row I will have a card, okay, with a class as card, and the card will have colon md3. Okay, this is basically a bootstrap class. You can just google it out why I'm making use of this colon md3. All right so it will just give a size of 3, okay, from out of a 12. Now what I'll do, I'll just have an image of the product. So I'll just have an image tag. Okay, image will have a source. Okay, so that image I will loop whatever I'm getting from the inside my product list. Okay, and also I will have a H5 for the title. Okay, when I say title, which means the title of my product. Okay, whatever I have. Okay, so I'll have inside my H5 tag, and I will have a P tag for the description. Okay, the product description if I want to show, and I'll also have a P tag. Okay, to show my prices, like what is the price and price of the product, and I will have a button. Okay, so for button is basically used for add to cart, that add to cart button which we have seen. Okay, so we'll have a class BTN and also class as BTN primary for the primary color. Okay, and the name will be add to cart. Okay, let me save things. All right, now for the H5 tag, what I'll do. Okay, so now what, so before just going further, what I'll do, I'll just loop all the data which I'm getting. Okay, so for looping in Angular, so we make use of ng4. Okay, so ng4 help us to loop all our data. So let me have a ng container. Okay, so inside the container I will put all the div which I have, the card which I have created, div card. Let's just cut this and paste inside this ng container. Okay, so I'll just have the ng4 loop. Let me loop the data, let item product list. All right, let me save it. So this product list is coming from here. Okay, which I have created, the property which I have created, it should match here. Okay, so let item of product. Now I have looped all the data inside. Now when I say item dot title, so it will print it for me. Let me show you that here. So I'm making use of this interpolation. Okay, so by interpolating I can just say that item dot title. Okay, let me save it and let's check on the browser what we get. Okay, so now you can see I have a card and with all my titles. Okay, here I can see the titles, whatever I was seeing on my Postman, that I can see here. Okay, now we just need to style a bit and just need to add some images so that it looks good. All right, so I will I have to loop with all my images as well. So for images I just have a source here. Okay, so let's me just make use of this item dot image. So I will loop all the images. All right, so now what I need to have, I need to have a H5 for the title. Okay, but I don't want to have that the full title name, because as you can see the title name looks very big. Okay, so what I'll make use, I'll just make use of the ellipse. Okay, so how I can do it, I'll just have to make use of the style. Okay, so let me have a style for that. Okay, let me just make use of the ellipse. So inside my style I will have white space. So whatever white space I have, I'll just tell that's no wrap. Okay, and I'll just overflow will be hidden, and it will just look like text overflow as a, whatever the text which is getting overflowed, so it will be shown as a 3 dot. Okay, so for that I just need to have ellipse. Okay, and also I can max width as a character. Okay, so I'll just give a max width of 100 characters, so 100 ch. When I save this thing and let's check on the browser how it looks. So I have all the images now. Okay, so but the styling is needed. Okay, but I was talking about this. Now the product looks like 3 dot dot dot. It is not showing all the product name. So how we have achieved this? We have achieved this by using this styling. Okay, so this is the important style to make you by which we can have the 3 dot. All right, so now let's try to have the description now. So let's try to loop the description. So how we can do, we just have to interpolate it. Okay, so we have already item, and then we just type item dot description. Okay, I'll just copy the same styling so that it should look 3 dot and it should look good on the browser. Let me copy the same styling for this as well, and also for price I will have a strong tag. Inside the strong I will have this price. Okay, and let me print, let me have the dollar sign for that, the pricing, and let me interpolate it with my price, item dot price. Let me save it and let's check on the browser.
Okay, so now here we have everything. We have the name of the product, some description and all that. All right. So now what I have to do, I just have to make use of it so that I can. Okay, but there was a problem, I guess. It was not showing as expected because the text. Let me just check why it is not showing, because here I just need three dot here. Okay, for that, the same thing I need to have here as well. So for styling, the spelling was incorrect, so it was not showing that. Now it will show. Let me go here and check. Yeah, so now it looks good. The description also have this three dot. All right. So now let's just style the images so that it looks good. Okay, but because currently it is all distorted. Okay, so I'll just try to just make the common width and height. I just have to pass the common width and height for all the images. So what I'll do, so inside my card class, whatever images I have, I want to style it. So I'll just give a width of 200 pixel and height of 200 pixel for all the cards. Okay, I'll give a margin bottom as 15 pixel. And just try to have some animation. So for that, I'll just transition of 0.3 second is in out. Okay. So whenever someone is hovering on my card, so for that also I need to just transform the scale so that it looks like something is getting zoomed. So just for that, I'll just have this card image, and on image hover, I will have a transition as the same 0.3 second. And I just need to transform the scale. Okay, so for that I'll just transform a scale with 1.1. okay, let me save and check on the browser now. All right, so now we can see we have this cool looking card now. So what next we need to do, we just have to give some padding. Okay, once we have some good padding, so the card will look in a very good manner. So for the card, I'll just give some padding of 20 or 50 pixel. Let's try to do that. Okay, let me in the CSS. Okay, for card, I will give a padding of 20 pixel and margin of something around 50 pixel maybe. Let's check how it looks. Yeah, it looks good now. So yeah, as you can see, we have our dashboard created. Okay, so now you can see I have this top header with this card top and all the product list page. Okay, so now next what we need to do, okay, so we need to create the card page. Okay, when I say card page, I am talking about this. Whenever I go on suppose my card is empty, so at that time I need to make this card. Okay, so let's try to do that now. Okay, so for creating this add to cart, okay, page, let's first try to configure our routing. Okay, for configuring routing, let's go to your app.routing.ts file. Okay, so let's try to do that first, and then we can head up to that creating that cart component. Okay. Alright, now I'm getting some error now. Okay, so I need to have this. Alright, now as you can see, we have this. Now let's try to have our router, because as we have configured our routing, so we must use a router link. Okay, so let's have our router link inside our app.component.html. Okay, let me remove this now because I have configured the product page already. Alright, so we'll have a router link below our app header, router outlet. Let me save things. Let's check on the browser. Now you can see on the top I have this routing configured. Okay, so whenever I have a blank, so it will redirect to my product page. If I just go here and just try to route to cart, just press You can see I'm on my cart page. Here you can see cart works. Okay, so now I have to make all the changes inside my cart component. So let's try to implement this thing now inside our cart. All right, so now we will try to create the UI for that my cart. Okay, just like this. Let me show you that what I'm saying. Okay, so we need to create this now. So let's try to do it. Okay, so let's go inside our HTML of cart component.html. Okay, so let's me save and check on the browser how it looks. Okay, so now we have things ready here. So now what we have to do, I just have to style this card a bit so that it looks good. So for styling, I just will make use of this class name card. Okay, yeah, now it has this thing. Now what we have to do, we have to make, this is our div. Okay, we have to make it so that it looks inside the center. Okay, the center of this card. So let's try to do it now. So for that, I'll make use of this class which we have created, center. Let me save and check how it looks now. Now it is in the center of this card. So one thing is, we just need an image here. So let's try to have that now. So for the image, I'm making use of that flip card. So I'll already have that snippet with me. I'll just copy it. Okay, and just paste here inside my source. So inside my source, I will have the link of that. Okay, so this is the source from where I'm copying. I'll have that, okay, inside our description. So what we just need to style it a bit so that it looks very good. So we just need to decrease the height of this. So what we'll do, we'll just style a bit to this particular image. So this image is basically inside your card. Okay, so let's open your card. Let me save and check on the browser now how it looks. Yeah, it looks, don't know why it is happening. Let's check in the CSS what is wrong. Okay, so width is only 225, sorry, it should be 250 pixel. Okay, now it looks good. Let's check. Now it looks good. Yeah, so yeah, so this, in this way we have created this my card card. Okay, so let's, so this looks little bit a darker loss. So let's try to decrease the boldness of that. So it is h4 and h6 tag. So font weight will have to decrease somewhat around 400. Okay, let's save and check now. That looks good now. Okay, so we have created this cart item now. Now what we have to do, we just have to create the table. Okay, so for creating table, I'll just tell you what exactly I'm saying. Suppose I'm adding anything to the card, all right, so at that time that card should get hidden. Okay, then that empty card, and it show this table. So let's try to implement this table now. All right, so what I'll do first, I'll just hide this container. I'll just copy all this, I'll just cut it, and I'll have a ng container, and inside this I will paste my container. Okay, and I will have a ng if, and I will make it false so that it should not shown on the browser. Okay, now what I have to code, I have to code for my table. Okay, so I'll have one more ng container. Okay, and I will have a condition as true that it should, that we can see it on the browser. So I will have ng if as true, and inside it I will have my code. Okay, that HTML code for that. So let's try to do it now. So for that container, just we'll need a card table, and inside the table I will create my card products, and inside it I will create my own table. So let's try to do it one by one. So I have told you, first I will have a card. So I'll have div dot card table. Okay, and inside this I will have one more div with a class name as card product. Okay, and inside it I will have my table now, table with a class as table and table responsive. Okay, and inside my table, the table has a table head. So I'll give a table head with th. Okay, and inside it, inside the table head, I will have a table row, and inside the row, I will have all the headers name. Okay, so let me put everything now. Okay, so we have created the table header. So let's create the table body. So let me save it and let's check on the browser. Okay, so now we have this table ready. Okay, so let's check what else is remaining. So let's try to implement an icon here. Okay, for that icon, we can make use of the font awesome. Okay, so let's try to do it to implement an icon inside it. So what I'll do, I'll just have the class here I with the class name as fas.fa.trash. So this is all the what we say, the font awesome class I'm using. Okay, let me save it and let's check on the browser now. You can see I have this trash kind of. Okay, so what else now I need? Okay, so I have this card, product has been ready and everything is done. So let me style a card a bit so that it looks same like this. Okay, so let's try to do it now. Okay, let me save and check on the browser how it looks now. So we have this cool looking card as well for this. Okay, so now what we need to do, we just have to focus on this particular thing. Okay, so we don't have a class container. Okay, so that's the reason it is not getting shrinked. Okay, so let me have a container class so that it looks a good, like it looks good basically. So what we'll do, we'll just have a class container. Okay, so let me just copy this thing, let me just cut it, and I'll have a div.container. And inside this, I will paste it. Okay. So now when I save it, it looks good. Let's check. Now you can see it is in little bit centralized. All right. So in this way, we have created the table as well. Okay, card table. Now what we need to do now, now whatever thing we are adding inside my card, so that I need to display in my table. So currently it is all static. So now we need to do it dynamically. So how can I do it? So let's check that. So before doing that, so till now whatever we have did, it was all simple and basic. So now the whatever you will do after this, it will be all quite complicated. So I'll want you guys to just focus and just pay attention whatever steps I'm using here. Okay, so for now, I'll for cart service. Okay, for adding all the product, I will create a service now. Okay, so let me create a service very quickly. So in my PowerShell, I will go, what is the command for creating service? It is ng s for service, and where I have to create the service, I have to create it inside my service folder. Okay, so I'll type the folder name service / and what is the name of the service? It is cart. Hit enter. So now you can see a service is created. You don't need this spec file. Okay, so I'm deleting it, and we are not doing any testing. So now your cart service is created. Okay, so now what you have to do here is, because whatever the call will go, okay, to your when we say the add to cart button, so at that time you have to call some method. Okay, so what I'll do is, because why we create service, whenever we want to pass any data across the component, across all the component, we create a service. So this is the reason I have created a service. Okay, so I'll have a property here, okay, as a public, as cart item list. Okay, and I have one more property as product list. All right, now I'm making use of a term behavior subject. Okay, so let me just import it from, so it is basically present inside your RxJS. Okay, let's press on tab and it will get imported on the top. Okay, so what does behavior subject do? Okay, so it basically act as both here. We can emit, we can also pass a value. So when we say pass value, we can emit a data to it, and it can also act as a subscriber. It can as an observable where anyone can subscribe whatever data has been emitted. Okay,
So this is the beauty of using a behavior subject. Okay, for behavior subject we need to initialize our initial data, so it will basically an array. Product list will be an array. Okay, so that I have did. So now what I will do, I'll have these two things first. Okay, so now I'll create all the methods which is required, okay, inside our service. So first of all, what I'll do, I'll just have a method called get products. Okay, so what it will do, whatever I have added, okay, because this product list will act as both, it will also act as observable and it will also helps to emit data as well. Okay, whenever we need to pass a data, so we'll do this dot product list dot next. So here in get product, I will create two things here, getter and setter. Okay, so from here I'll do a get product. So what I'll do, this dot product list dot as observable. Okay, and I need to return it. Okay, so wherever, whoever will call this get product, they will get the data whatever is present inside it. Okay, so I will return this dot product list as observable. Okay, so now whoever will make use of this get product, they can subscribe to it, whatever data present inside this product list. All right, so this is basically our getter. Now let's create a set product. Okay, so let me do it, set product, and so it will have a parameter inside it of type, like it will have a product inside it and that we can set. Okay, so what I will do, so this dot cart item list dot push, I will push whatever it is coming inside it. Okay, I will push the product item. Okay, so I'll make use of the spread operator and I will push this product inside this cart list, cart item list. Okay, and what at the same time what I want to do, I want to emit the data as well. So what I have told you, this can act as both, this can also emit and this can also be subscribed. So what I'll do, I'll just try to emit now whatever value it is inside it. So I'll do this dot product list dot next. When I say next, this data will get passed wherever it has been subscribed. Okay, so I want to pass the data of this product. Okay, so in this way what we have created a getter and setter. Okay, this is very important. All right guys, so how we have did it, we have make use of this behavior subject to try to implement this getter and setter, get and set product. All right, so now let's try to do create our third method, which will be add to cart. Add to cart. So what it will do, it will also take a parameter product. Okay, and inside it what it will do, it will just take whatever the item it is present inside your cart. So what it will do, it will just do this dot cart list item list dot push, push the product inside it whatever we are like passing. So this product will get pushed inside it whenever we are saying add to cart. Okay, and now what we'll do, we will also emit at the same time. So this dot product list dot next, when I say next, it will get passed wherever it is called. Okay, wherever it is subscribed, whoever is subscribing the product list, so we are passing this cart item to it. All right, and now I'll also create one more method which is called this dot get total amount, because we need to have the total price as well. Okay, so I'll create a total price method as well, which will helps to get the price of the product. Okay, total price of the product list whichever we are having. So let me try to create this method below it. Okay, all right, so what this get total will do, it will just take your values, whatever the cart item values, and will total all the value which is present inside it. So let's do it, let's create a variable, let grand total, current it will be 0. Okay, so now what we will do, we'll just take the cart item list. Okay, and we will map the data. All right, we'll make use of this array, we have this inside array, we can make use of this map. So A, basically it will take all the items present inside this cart list. Okay, this A will have everything. So now let's try to add all the product here. So now what we'll do, we'll make use of this grand total, it will take all the value from it and it will just add it. Okay, so initially it was 0 and now it will add the total whatever value present inside your this basically this cart item list. All right, so it will total everything. So in this way we have created three things now: set product, add to cart, and get total price. So this helps in all that. Now what we will do, now we'll have to create two things. Now we have to remove cart item and we have to remove all cart, because we were having two features here, as you can see. we can just remove all the item. Okay, so we have this empty card and we also have this single remove as well. So we'll have to implement it now. So let's do it. So now what I'll do, I'll just have a method called remove cart item. Okay, and what it will take a parameter as product. All right, and what it will do, it will make use of this cart item list and it will map the data as per our requirement. Okay, so now what it has two things. Okay, I'll take the whatever the list present inside and I'll also make use of the index. Okay, index means at which one we need to remove it. Okay, so it will help in that. So let's create it now, this remove item list. So what we will check, we will check if the product item ID match with the ID which is present inside our list. So we have this product on the top. So inside the product, we have a ID as well, product ID. If our product ID matches our ID of the list, inside the list which we have. So A.ID, if it matches, then we have to remove it. So what we will do for removing a data from an array, so we make use of the splice. So we'll take this dot card item, which is our array dot splice. Okay, what we have to splice, the index item, okay, where it is present. So we have this index which we had inside this map and have to remove one item, okay, from the array. All right, so in this way you can remove one item from the cart, okay, by this method. All right, so now I will create a last method of this service, which is your remove all. So this is very simple, quite straightforward. So we have remove all cart. Okay, so what we will do, we'll just have to empty the cart. So how we can empty a cart, we can just say this dot cart item list is equals to empty. Okay, and at the same time I want to pass this data to my product list because it has been subscribed, this dot product list dot next. Okay, and I will pass this cart item list. Okay, this dot cart item list. Let me save it. Yeah, so compile successfully and we have everything ready now. We have created our service. Okay, so now we have to make use of this service, okay, inside our products. All right, so let's do it now. So inside our product, we can see we have already ng on, we have the product list already. Okay, so what we will do is whenever I click on the button, okay, add button, so it will trigger some method. Okay, so it should trigger a method. So let's create a method first inside our product list, that add to cart, and I want to use this method where inside our HTML file, wherever I have created my button, okay, add to cart. So on this click event, I want to call this method whenever I click. Okay, so what I will do, I'll just pass the item, okay, inside. So let me paste it, and what I want to pass the item. Let me just copy this and paste inside this. Okay, so whatever row data will be there, so it will get passed to this add to cart. Okay, so now we are passing a parameter here as item. So the same thing we need to do here as well, okay, inside our TS file. So we are passing a parameter from the UI as item, okay, and that item will consist of the product list, or that product item which it has. All right, so now what we need to do, we need to add to cart that particular page. So what we'll do, we'll just call the service which we have created. Okay, so first we need to inject inside our constructor. How we can inject, we just have to say private and say cart service, and we need to just import the cart service now which we have created, cart service. See, we are getting this. Let's press on tab, it will get auto imported as well on the top. So let's use this cart service because we in the service we have created for adding a product to our cart. Okay, so we have to call this method now. So let's do it here. So what we will say, we'll just say this dot cart service dot add to cart, and this add to cart we have passed the product. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll just pass this item value to this. Okay, so in this way we just completed this add to cart, the one step of using the method, because whatever service we have created, we have to use it somewhere. Okay, so we have made use of this particular add to cart now. All right, we have completed this add to cart. Okay, so I need to share something here, that when you see my API, so inside my API I have this key as title, price, description, category and image. Okay, but when you see my tables, okay, let me just open my tables here.
this add to cart table. Okay, so I have this two more thing extra. Just let me just route to cart. Okay, and here if you see that I have a quantity and total, okay, which I need to add. Okay, so how I can add these two inside my object? So let's try to do it now. So what I will do, I'll just loop this. Okay, so I'll make use of for each loop here. Okay, so what I will do, I'll just do this dot product list dot for each. Okay, and inside it I'll just have an element A, and what I will do is I'll just assign an object to it. Okay, I'll do object dot assign. Okay, so it says what is your source, basically what is the target. I have one target is my A, and what I have to assign, I have to assign two things. The first is my quantity. Okay, so quantity as one by default quantity, and I will also tell the total. Okay, a total as A dot price. So whatever my price will be initially, it will be my total. Okay, so in this way I can do it. So let me save it. So yeah, so we are now completed with the API call of this. Okay, whatever we have created for get product. Okay, so now let's try to make use of it. Let's check how it is happening. Okay, so whatever I'll do, I'll just try to console log here inside my service. When I say add to cart, so let me just here console the cart item. Okay, so that we can check, verify if things are working or not. When I say this dot cart item, let me save it. Let's go on the browser now. Let me open the product page. Let me refresh the page and just open up my console. Okay, so whenever I say add to cart here, you can see it is getting added inside my list. When I say second product, the second product has been added. Okay, so my cart item is getting increased now whenever I press on add to cart. Okay, now when you see this, so I have added two things. One is your quantity and another is your total. Okay, so that is also getting appended inside it. Okay, so my add to cart things are working now inside my console. So now what we have to do, I have to pass this data now to this particular cart item. Okay, so that it will display inside our table. Okay, so let's try to do it now. So now we know that whenever I want to click here, so it will get data here. Okay, so now let's try to configure the routing for this. Whenever we click on this button, so it should open up the cart page. Okay, let's try to do it now. Let me open up my this product list and this HTML. Below I was having that button inside my header. Sorry, let me go inside my header dot HTML, and there you will see you will have a button there. Okay, so inside the button, on that click I will have to route. Okay, so for route I can directly pass the router link here. Okay, so what I'll do is say that router link, and where I want to route, I want to route it to cart items. Okay, and I just press cart, and when I go there, when I press here on this button, so it will redirect me to this cart page. Okay, so whenever I'm clicking on this button, it is sending me to this cart page. Okay, so now what our requirement, second requirement is, when I'm clicking on this, at that time the number should also change. So now let's try to do it now. So let's see how we can do it. Okay, so for that, I'll do inside our header file. Okay, when you say inside your header, so there must be something which is counting that number, because that number is present inside your header. All right, so what we will do, we'll just call the product list inside our header component. Let's open up the header component now. Okay, so inside the header component, inside the ng on init, what I will do, I will call the service. Okay, the service, the cart service which I have created. So I'll say private cart service. Okay, and just call that service name. Okay, so I have injected the service now. Now what I will do, I'll just call the get product. Okay, so this dot cart service dot get products. Okay, so when I subscribe it, okay, so I'll get the response when it is success. So I'll take the response. Okay, and inside that I will try to store, okay, like how many items are is there inside my cart. So what I will do, I'll first create a property. Okay, total cart items. Let me create a property where x public total item. Okay, and it will be of type number, and let me initialize it with zero first. Okay, so now what I will do, I will store the total number of items. Okay, so that it can display there inside that red badge. Okay, so I'll do this dot total item will be equals to my response, which is coming, okay, dot length. Okay, let me save it. And now what I have to do, I want to display this on my header. Okay, so I will interpolate it. Let me interpolate this here. Where is my total number? It is here. Okay, wherever I have written 5. So I will just make use of interpolation with this total item. Let me save it and let me just check on the browser now. So currently it is 0. When I click on any item, you will see the number is getting changed to 1. When I click on second item, the number is changed to 2. The same way, number changes to 3 whenever I click this. Okay, so now the number has been changed. Okay, now what I have to do, I want to add product as well whenever I click over there. So let's try to do it now. So for that, I need to do some changes inside my cart.component.ts file. So let's open the cart.component.ts. Okay, I have to do the same thing here as well. So what I will do, I will store the values, right? Because whatever is coming from my get products, I need to store that. So what I'll do, I'll have a product, a property called as product list, or we can say just product. Okay, it will be type is any and it is an array. Okay, so second thing, I will have a grand total, because what is the total which we are getting? So I'll have, we'll store it in some different variable. Okay, it will be of type number and I will initialize it to 0. Okay, so now let's try to do the same thing as here also. I need to inject my cart service, so I'll do the same thing here as well. Let me inject it, cart service. So now what I'll do, I'll just call the particular what we say, the method which we are having, which we have implemented inside that. All right, so let's do it. So it will say this dot cart service dot get products. Okay, and when I say subscribe, so it will return all the value which is present inside it. Okay, so here when I say response in the success response, I will store all the data which is coming. Okay, so I'll product, this dot product will be equal to my response. So response data will go inside this product now. All right, and for grand total, what I can do, I'll just have to call the second method which I've created, get total product. So I'll do this dot grand total is equals to this dot cart service dot get total price. Okay, so now it throws an error that the void is not assignable to type number. Okay, so let me just have this as let me just remove the number type, and what I'll do is I'll just try to change the data type there. Okay, inside my service, inside my cart service, I will have it as type as number, and it will return grand total. Okay, so now let's go inside your cart component. The error is gone. Okay, so now we have like completely done. Now what we have to do, I want to loop this data with my table. So how can I do it? It's quite simple. Let's try to do it. As we know that we make use of ng4 for looping the array. Okay, so the same thing we'll use here as well. Okay, so inside this tr, what I will do, I'll make use of ng4. Okay, let me use ng4 here. Okay, and say let item of products. Okay, this name should match your this property name. Okay, so I'll have the same name as product here as well. Okay, and also what I will do, I want to have the index number, that for the serial number. So I'll do let I equals to index. Okay, now what I want to do, I want to just interpolate everything here. So let's do the interpolation. So I starts from 0, so I'll initialize it with 1, I plus 1. And for name, I want to have as item.title. Okay, item dot title. So now if you see that I also have a button, alright, so which is used for deleting the if you want to remove a single product. Alright, so I'll have that here as well. When I click the button, it will call a remove method. Okay, let me create that as well. When I click, so it should call a method. The method name is remove item. And I will pass the item which I want to remove. Okay. Let me create this method on TS, else it will throw an error. So let me copy this and let me try to create a method here, remove item, and item will be of type any. Okay. Now let me save things. Now let's try to write this for remove item. We have already created the service. We just need to inject the service again and just call the service cart service dot remove cart item. We need to just remove single item. I'll just pass the item which I want to remove. Okay, and this will work. Okay, in the same way I will have one more method which was for empty cart. For I want to remove all the item of the cart, so I'll just call this method empty cart. Okay, let me create the method and I'll just make use of the service again, cart service dot remove all cart. Okay, it will just call the method. Okay, from this. Alright, so in this way we have completed like for getting all the products inside our cart and removing a single item and removing all the item. Let me save everything and let's go to our browser. Okay, let me add a product here. Let me add a second product. Let me go to this. Now you can see we are getting this all the product inside our table. Alright. So now if you try to remove this item, let me remove it. So see, you can remove a single item as well. Alright. If suppose there is no item present, so it should display this page. Okay. So let's try to do this. Let's try to implement it. Okay. So let's go inside our cart component.html. And what I'll do, I'll have a condition here. Okay. So the condition will be quite simple. Okay. So when I want to show and when I don't want to show. So I'll have an ng if. Alright. So if my products dot length, okay, if it is not equal to 0, so at that time it will show. Okay, let me save it, and for this I will have a condition that suppose if my length is, so it will be just reverse. Okay, if it is 0, then at that time it should show display basically. So products dot length, if it is equal to 0, so at that time this will display. Let me save it. And let's check on the browser now. Now see, if there is no item, so at that time it is showing this page. Okay, so now let me just add a product. When we click on this shop now, it should route me to that particular page. So let's try to do that now for this shop now. Let's go to this shop now, which is present inside here. And on this button, I will have a router link. Okay, and this router link will be go wherever I want to like route my product. I want to route it to products page. Okay, so it will just go to the products page. Let me save it. And if I click on this shop now, it will route me to this particular page, to my dashboard page of my product list. Now let me add something from here and let's check. Now you see, now we can't see that my cart page, and we can see this table now. And when I remove one by one all the item, so now you see it is showing me this. All right so now let's try to do it again. Let's check what things we have did right now. So there is one thing to notice here, that whenever I add a product, okay, so this number is getting changed, right? But when I remove the items, see, the number is still the same. Okay, so let's try to fix it, why it is happening. Okay, let's check. Let's go inside our service, cart service. Okay, so when I am removing it, so what I'll do, so for every move I need to update the number as well. So what I'll do, I'll just this dot product list dot next, so I'll pass the updated value of the cart list. Okay, so I'll just say this dot cart list, cart item list. All right and same for the remove item as well. So whenever I'm removing all the items, so at that time it will just update the list. Let me save it and let's check if that problem is fixed or not. Okay, so now let's try to shop now. Okay, let me just add two products. Okay, now let's try to remove one. Now see, it is getting updated. Okay, Yeah, so let's so it is done. So now what is remaining now? Now I need to have three things on the back on the bottom. Let me tell you what I'm saying. So whenever I'm adding something, so in the bottom I need this empty cart, shop more and checkout and this grand total. So let's try to implement this bottom part now. Alright, to create the bottom three products, so what you need to do, you need to go into your cart.component.html file, okay, and here like below this tr you need to create a one more tr, okay, table row, okay. So below it what you will do, above the t body, okay, where the t body is closed, above that you need to have a tr, okay, and there you will have a td, okay, and this will have a cool span, okay. I'll tell you why I'm having this cool span, okay. So it will leave the starting four column, and from the last four column it will have this all this data, okay. So we have four buttons there, so I'll have a button danger btn.btn danger is basically for red color. We have this in bootstrap, okay, and it says that empty cart, okay, the label as empty cart. In the same way I'll create two more buttons, okay. So one, but this button is will be for shop more, and we'll create one more now for checkout. All right, so I'll just give the color as primary for shop more, and for this checkout I will say success. Let me save and check on the browser how it looks. Okay, to check the table I need to add something first, and table. So we have these three buttons now, and this all looks little bit distorted. So this is because of styling. We need to style this column, okay. We need to give some width to this, okay. Let's try to do this. All right, so what we need to do, we just need to style some of my field, okay. I'll just do all the inline styling here. Just give style to this description, okay. So I'll add a width as 25%. And let me add some width for this as well. We'll have width of 12%. I think 12 will be fine for rest of the table headers. Let me just copy it and paste here. Let me save it and let's check on the browser. Okay, so we are facing an error here. It says TD tag. Okay, TD tag has been alright. So there's a mistake here. I just need to remove this. Let me save now. Okay, I just copied everything, so that's the reason it is throwing an error. Okay, I have removed it. Control save. Yeah, compiled successfully. Let's check on the browser now how it looks. Let's shop something. Add a product. So now you can see it looks very clean and good. Okay, so now what I need to do, I need to have the functionality for this empty cart, okay, and for this shop more, okay. So let's try to do it. Okay, when I press on this empty cart, it should call the method which I have created, okay. So on that click, I need to call this method. Let remove all, okay, it will remove all my cart items at once. So I'll just call this method for this empty cart. So on that click, it will call that, okay. Let me just paste here empty cart, and for this shop more I need to route it to the product page again, okay. So I'll make use of this router link and it will route me to the product page, okay. Let me save it and let's check how it works. Now again let me add some product here, and let me add 2-3 product now. Let's go inside my cart item, okay. Let me try to remove one. Yeah, it is working. Let me try to remove all the item, okay. All the item has been removed, okay. So in the same way let me check for the other button as well, for shop more. Suppose I have added one item, I need to shop more. When I click on shop more, okay, I'm again routed to this page and I can add more items now, and I can go ahead and check, okay. Yeah, things are working fine. Now one thing is remaining, that I need to have a grand total also over here, okay, somewhere here, okay. Let's try to do that now. Okay, so what I need to do, I just need to go inside my HTML and I will have one more TD, okay, here below, and I will have a strong tag for the grand total. and I can have a currency as dollar, and I'll just interpolate which we have created a property here, the grand total. Okay, let me copy this and paste it here inside this two curly bracket. Let me save it and let's check now how it works on the browser. So now when I shop anything, so we must get a total item, like total amount, okay, which we are shopping. We have added two product now. We can see the grand total here. This is the addition of these two total. All right, so in this way we have like completed this part also. So let me try to do empty here and go to shop more again. Okay guys, so this was all about creating an add to cart in Angular. Okay, so let's try to just demo it once. So whenever I click on this add to cart, you can see the cart is getting added here and the number is getting also changed. When I press on this cart, so it will display me this table where it will have all the price, quantity and total and everything. And below here you can see we have these three buttons. Okay, so only two buttons functioning here, like for empty cart and shop more. When I click on shop more, I will again redirect it to this particular product page and I can add some more item here. And by adding here, the number will also get changed again. And yeah, in the bottom you can see I will have a grand total now. If I want to remove one by one, so that I can do, okay. We can remove a single product. If I need to empty all the cart items, so I just have to press this button. And then we have this cool looking UI as well, that my cart, it says that your cart is empty. All right. So this was all about creating an add to cart in Angular. I know I have skipped one thing here, that how if I need to implement this search kind of feature. So this will do in our next video, because this is a different topic where I need to create a search pipe. All right. And also I need to create a filter pipe for this, that I need to filter by electronics product, fashion product or jewelry product. If you feel like any error in like creating this application, then please I will request you guys to, you can mention your all your doubts and queries in the comment section. I will definitely be there to answer each and every questions, whatever do you have. All right. So till that time, bye bye and keep learning.